you've got an overarching view this morning. We're going to get into the details in just a moment. But you think this is about expectations just collapsing over the last year and beating that bar. Just explain that a little bit further, Rich.
Yeah, I mean, look, when you think about Disney, remember, in May of 2018, I think consensus expectations for fiscal September 19 were $7.80. They just reported $5.77. So, you know, obviously there's been a lot that's changed for Disney in terms of the composition. They went out and they bought Fox. The Fox asset obviously has dramatically underperformed their expectations. But, look, it was a very solid beat for Disney. And I think the issue, though, is really Disney stock is not trading on earnings. You know, I know people are making a lot out of they beat this kind of low bar for Q4, fiscal Q4. But this is all about building excitement for Disney Plus and especially the other streaming services. I mean, look, what we learned yesterday is that Disney's getting super serious about Hulu with a major announcement about what they're going to do with FX, ESPN Plus with 3.5 million subs. So we saw a reacceleration in what had been stagnating growth on the ESPN Plus side. Disney stock is now a proxy for their streaming efforts. I think much more so than anything that they reported in terms of what happened over the last 12 months.
So let's explore that further, Rich. You think the excitement is misplaced? How so?
I don't know if it's misplaced. I just think, like, this is investors getting excited for next Tuesday's launch of Disney Plus, and I think getting excited that Hulu now has far more of a strategy. You know, what they did yesterday, really a watershed moment for the cable industry yesterday. Disney is telling you that the FX programming, so when you see a new hit show on FX, hours later, that show is going to be on Hulu. So you don't need a cable bundle to get FX programming. That's the first time we've ever seen that. I mean, yes, before you could wait a year and it would end up on a Netflix or it would end up on an Amazon. Now, hours later, just like you can with broadcast TV with Hulu, now that programming is going to end up from FX on Hulu. That's a major change and really is sort of Bob Iger and the team at Disney acknowledging that the legacy cable bundle essentially is dead. I mean, this is basically putting the cable bundle in the rearview mirror for Disney, even though they still own big assets like ESPN.